A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 16th May, on the front page you have violence prompts poll panel to pull campaign plug in Bengal. So this is regarding West Bengal. The election commission has cut electioneering by a day, and it says fear psychosis is widely prevalent in the state. So we had seen in earlier phases of elections too, when violence was evident in West Bengal. So now in this unprecedented move, Election Commission has imposed a blanket ban on political parties' campaigning activities in the 9 parliamentary constituencies of West Bengal, so which will go for polls in the last phase. And this is Supreme Court decries Sharma's detention. So this is regarding BJP Yuva Morcha leader Priyanka Sharma. So Supreme Court has pulled up West Bengal government on putting her behind bars overnight, despite court's 14th May order to release her immediately on bail. And this is monsoon to reach Kerala on June 6th. So Indian Meteorological Department's forecast expects slight delay. So this is now, it will come by June 6th. Normally, monsoon comes to Kerala on 1st June. On page 2, you have, don't opt for POK varsities, ministry. So this is Ministry of Human Resource Development, which has directed students from Jammu and Kashmir to avoid enrolling for any courses in universities in Pakistan-occupied Kashmir. So this has evoked sharp reaction from students and separatists. Actually, POK region, they have kept a 6% reservation for students from the Indian part of Kashmir. So this UGC advisory has also evoked sharp reaction. So it is an advisory issued on May 8 by University Grants Commission Secretary, which cautioned students against taking admission in unapproved institutions in Pakistan-occupied Kashmir. So it is said there are around 25 students from JNK pursuing their courses in medical colleges in POK. So these 5 medical colleges have kept 6% reservation for the students. Then on page 3, you have pest struck Mizoram farmers hit by lack of crop insurance. So here pest attack has happened, and around 5,309 families in Mizoram have been affected because of this attack of fall armyworm, FAW. So here they have not even insured their crops. Even the government has the Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana, which aims to provide insurance coverage and financial support to farmers in the event of failure of any of the notified crops due to natural calamities, pests and diseases. So the prescribed premium in Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana is 2% to be paid by farmers for all kharif crops and 1.5% for rabi crops. Remaining, remaining premium has to be paid by the government. So government bears the expense even if the balance premium is 90%. So that is the case here. So even for commercial and horticulture crops, the premium is high, but they provide insurance for that too. So the thing is that in Mizoram, it is said that Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana could not be introduced. So it is said this was because there was no desirable company. The insurance company has to take up the tender. Tender was floated for the purpose, but no desirable company took it up. So we have floated a fresh tender now. But then presently these farmers crops are not insured, and this is the situation here. So help is being sought from farm center and NGOs as such. This is what the agriculture ministry says. On page 5, you have, after 29 years of service, Vigraha decommissioned. So this is Indian Coast Guard ship ICGS Vigraha, which was decommissioned at Vishakhapatnam. So it has served the Coast Guard for 29 years and has been decommissioned with full military honours now. Then on page 7, you have, slain commando skin may not get rupees 20 lakh insurance money. So this is a major embarrassment to Maharashtra government. We saw in news how an Excel attack in Gadchiroli this month had resulted in 15 police commandos being killed. So they would not get, then the next to kin, their kin would not get, their relative would not get insurance benefit of rupees 20 lakh. And the reason for this being because Maharashtra police failed to renew the group insurance policy offered under the security related expenditure fund until last year. So it had to renew it, but it was not renewed. So these slain commandos skin would not get the insurance. So that is a major embarrassment here. Then next is, Jammu and Kashmir High Court seeks report on rape of minor girl by tomorrow. So this is regarding the rape of a 3-year-old girl as such in Jammu and Kashmir. So there are street protests going on. Religious leaders have called for peace, but the protests continue. And this is Odisha pegs losses at 11,942 crores. So this is cyclone hit Odisha state, which presented a preliminary report to the visiting central team and says the losses are to the tune of rupees 11,942 crores. And this is Supreme Court penalizes Bihar government officials for lethargy. So it has ordered Bihar government to collect a fine of 20,000 from the pockets of its officers whose lethargy led to 728-day delay in filing of an appeal in the apex court. So they say that it took time because they had to take sanctions from various departments, receive the affidavit and wakalatnama from the department concerned. So that is why there was this 728-day delay, which is more than a year. But the Supreme Court bench said that the state government should not feel that they can approach courts at will and the judiciary is obliged to take up the case of the state. So it has asked for fine now, penalty from each of these officials of Bihar government. Then below you have NIN stands by its report on no onion garlic in its meals. So the National Institute of Nutrition said that it stands by its findings certifying midday meals without onion and garlic provided by Akshay Patra Foundation in Karnataka schools. So it says it is compliant with the nutritional norms laid by the state government. So this is the case here. On the editorial page, the first editorial is morphed freedoms. So this is regarding the front page news yesterday regarding this mobbed photo of Mamata Banerjee by a BJP member, BJP Yuva Morcha member. So this had resulted in her being put in jail and the Supreme Court was approached, which allowed her to be granted bail. So by seeking an apology while granting bail, the Supreme Court downplayed the misuse of law. So this is what the editorial says. So it gave order for immediate bail, but it also asked the BJP Yuva Morcha functionary to seek an apology from the government. So that is uncalled for, is what the article editorial says. And this is chasing stability. So this editorial says that climate change and energy policies are top of the agenda in Australia's elections. So in Australia, elections are due and these are the two major issues: climate change and energy. The lead article is why the Muslim vote matters in UP. So it says marginalized and fearful Muslim voters want to demonstrate that they can still count in India's democracy. So it's election related, you can skip it. All out at sea. So this is regarding India's engagement in the Indian Ocean, which reveals a tactical, proactive, but strategically defensive mindset. So this is in the context of how we have demonstrated, regional navies have demonstrated in the Indian Ocean, how Indian Navy is also capable of resolving, you know, and persevering operational leverage in India's near seas. Then on op-ed page, you have this article, The Need for Judicial Restraint. So it says lawmaking is not the job of the judges, but of the legislature. So many a time Supreme Court goes into directing and making laws, like, you know, the judgment on ordering time limits to burst firecrackers on Diwali. So it's a function of the legislature, judgment on linking rivers, so on which there is no parliamentary legislation. Then unpredictable decisions in cases related to freedom of speech and expression, like the BJP Yuva Morcha case, so in which the apology was also asked to be sought. So it says lawmaking is not the job of the judges, but of the legislature. And then you have, then on international page, you have US orders staff to leave Iraq embassy. So Trump administration says that it has intelligence that Iranian activity puts facilities and personnel at risk. So it has asked staff to leave the Iraq embassy now. And this is Facebook to curb live streaming. So the Facebook would ban users who share extremist content now. So live streaming will be stopped. There will be restrictions on it. So even this was the case of a New Zealand attacker who had, you know, live streamed his attack. So such violent videos being live streamed, that has to be regulated. Then this is Xi Jinping rejects clash of civilizations theory. So Chinese president says a global community with shared future is possible and there is no clash of civilizations. On business page, you have Tata Chem Consumer Arm TGBL to merge. So, with eye on higher share of foods and beverages markets, Tata companies give nod for this new structure where the consumer arm would be merged as such. So, this is regarding Tata's consumer business. So, substantial revenue and cost synergies are likely to be achieved by combining the two entities. Then below you have RBI envisions fourfold growth in digital transactions by 2021. So it says over 100% average annualized growth is expected in UPI, unified public interface, unified payment interface, and IMPS. So this is likely. And IMPS stands for immediate payment service. Then next is exports growth slides to 4-month low in April. So trade gap is at a 5-month high. Imports are rising. Crude oil and gold imports remain stable. They keep rising, but exports have slid. So this is the news. And on the last page, you have China blocks Wikipedia in all languages. So articles on pro-democracy protests had long been inaccessible, but now it is a total shutdown of Wikipedia in China. And below you have this dinosaur had bat-like wings. So this is regarding the fossil first found by Chinese scientists who thought it was a bird. So this is actually a dinosaur which had bat-like wings. So a team of paleontologists in China have recently announced this discovery of a dinosaur that sported the same kind of fleshy wings bats use to flit through the air. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aasia.com. The PDF for the news is also available by the end of the day. Also, for detailed video coverage, also there's a separate course which you can enroll for. Thank you.